प्रथमे प्रथमे मोय शिक्षार्थी सकलो आंतरिक अभिनंदन जानाइछि। I commend the efforts of all the students who have received their degrees, diplomas and medals at this 19th convocation of Tezpur University. It is a very important day for all the students, their family members and teachers too. I also congratulate all the teachers and guardians on this happy occasion. Getting an opportunity to live and study in this beautiful and spacious campus must be a delight in itself. In this campus, one gets a feel of the natural beauty of Assam and the hospitality of the people here. Dear students, you have spent your university days in a city which is associated with great cultural icons like Roop Kunwar, Jyoti Prasad Agarwala, Kala Guru Vishnu Prasad Rabha, Nat Surya Fani Sharma and Bharat Ratna Dr. Bhupen Hazarika. I hope you have read their biographies to learn about the great cultural traditions of India and the Northeast. Dear students, you must be proud of the fact that your Vishwavidyalaya Geet was written and composed by the great Bhupen Hazarika. The university song has a very meaningful line that says, Manavata Bador Dhyanor Pratik Tezpur Vishwavidyalaya, which means that Tezpur University is a symbol of concern for humanity. This line echoes his famous song, Manuve Manuhar Bhave. That is, a human being lives for other human beings. This feeling of compassion for entire humanity should be your guiding principle. You should draw inspiration from the great personalities associated with this university and the city of Tezpur and resolve to contribute to the well-being of the people of India and the world. The glorious traditions of the past should inspire you to work for a great future. Ladies and gentlemen, it is heartening to note that the states in the Northeast give high priority to organic farming. The university can play a major role in branding and marketing of agriculture produce of this season. I am happy to note that the university has received approval under the Prime Minister formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises Scheme for setting up an incubation center to process jackfruit and ready-to-eat cereals-based products. I am told that the Food Engineering and Technology Department has been recognized as a state-level technical institute for implementation of this scheme. In this context, I am reminded of the unique Johar Rice of Assam, which is known for its excellent taste and aroma. It need not be cooked in hot water. It can be put in normal water for a few minutes and can be relished after that. Universities of Assam can help the farmers by branding, popularizing and marketing this unique variety of rice. There are many such agricultural products that can be promoted. Ladies and gentlemen, Assam is gifted with extraordinary beauty of nature and rich biodiversity. This has to be preserved. Every resident of Assam, especially the youth, has to be very active on the fronts of conservation and sustainable development. I am glad to know about the renewable energy initiatives of the university, especially in the villages. The young population has greater stakes in keeping the planet green. They have to demonstrate greater awareness through their action. Assam has done a commendable job in conserving biodiversity. Kaziranga National Park and Tiger Reserve, as also the Elephant Reserve, are impressive examples of conservation. During this visit, I will be going to Kaziranga National Park and will also inaugurate an exhibition on conservation. Conservation must be the watchword for every citizen, especially the student community. Development initiatives for the eastern part of India, especially the northeast, are being given a special thrust. I appreciate the efforts of the Assam government led by the Chief Minister, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, for onward march of Assam on the path of progress. The young population is both a drive and a key beneficiary of development and progress. I am happy to note that the university is promoting collaboration with major industries. I am also happy about the university having substantial number of consultancy projects in different areas of development. Dear students, your academic activities have been affected by the COVID pandemic. The pandemic has had serious impact on the education of the relatively vulnerable sections of our people. The National Education Policy 2020, which was released during the pandemic, contains a specific focus on digital education with the help of technology, with a view to making higher education more accessible. The central government has decided to establish a digital university to provide access to students across the country for world-class quality universal education with personalized learning experience at the doorsteps of students. The digital university will provide education in different Indian languages and ICT formats. Tejpur University can become an active stakeholder in this initiative, especially by providing high quality digital content in Assamese and other languages of the Northeast. Dear students, the students and faculty of Tejpur University should try to make it a major center of innovation. The university community should provide innovative solutions to local and national problems. For this, community participation and use of local resources should be encouraged. I am happy to know about innovative solutions provided by Tejpur University for reaching safe drinking water to many villages in Assam. The scope of the university's engagement with villages should be further expanded. As a visitor of the institutions of higher education under the central government, I have been encouraging the institutions to promote university's social responsibility, or USR, on the lines of corporate social responsibility. Engagement of the students with the rural population is one of the key features of university social responsibility. Tejpur University can adopt some villages for helping in their overall development. The National Education Policy 2020 also seeks to provide pathways for the future in a globalized world while preserving time-honored Indian values like compassion, morality, truth, and good conduct. The motto of this university, Vigyanam Yagyam Tante, reflects the approach of blending the eternal with the futuristic. The motto, taken from a mantra in the Taittiriya Upanishad, lends itself to different rich interpretations. The university has adopted it to mean specialized knowledge promotes creativity. The mantra in the Upanishad, just after the adopted motto, says Karmani Tante Apitya, which would mean specialized knowledge promotes action too. Thus, while Tejpur University seeks to promote specialized knowledge or creativity, it should also seek to promote action. Action-oriented creativity and learning should be the composite message as contained in the excellent motto of your university. Dear students, I appreciate the establishment of the Center for Multidisciplinary Research in the university to undertake research problems with social cleanliness. The university having more than 300 research projects amounting to a total grant of nearly rupees 95 crores is a promising development. I want to share with you all my happiness in having approved Visitor Award to the esteemed faculty members of the university in the year 2021 for technology and development related to physics, and in the year 2018 for research related to molecular biology and biotechnology. Ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to observe that Tezpur University has been promoting women empowerment through education. I am told that about 1250 students graduated today, out of whom about 45% are women. Out of the 47 students who have been awarded gold medals, 27 are our daughters, which is much more than half of the total numbers of gold medals. Let us give a big hand. I have observed this trend of our daughters outperforming the boys in most of the convocations I have attended. This excellence displayed by women is a reflection of India's future as a gender-just nation. I convey my special congratulations to each and every daughter for her distinct achievements today. I urge upon the entire team of Tezpur University to keep past, present, and future students bound by the spirit of oneness and move rapidly towards the goals set by the university. Opan, Bogom, Tibro, Gati, Gotire. By moving fast to achieve ambitious targets, the university will be able to contribute meaningfully to India's emergence as a much more prosperous and strong nation by the year 2047, when the students of today will be among the decision makers. The real spirit behind celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, marking 75 years since our independence, is to build upon our learning so far and aim for higher goals. Tezpur University should strive to be among the top 10 universities in the NIRF ranking in the near future. I once again congratulate the students for their achievements. I also appreciate the teachers and staff who made the achievements possible for the students. The Vice Chancellor and his team deserve to be congratulated too. The residents of Assam, especially the students, are fortunate to have the sage counsel of the Governor, Professor Jagdish Mukhiji, who himself is from the world of academia. My best wishes to all of you for all your endeavors to make your own life and the lives of the people of India better. Thank you. Jai.